It is important for us to know where microplastics are coming from and where they are going in order for us to know where to focus our efforts on. Often resources are very limited, so the little that we have, we need to use it very wisely. We have different types of environments in our ecosystems, and some are more vulnerable than others. For example, we have marshy grounds or mangrove areas, which are breeding grounds for new fishes and turtles, etc. So they will become more vulnerable than other places. So they will probably need more protection than others. If we are able to put these microplastics on a map, it helps us to geolocate where these plastics are and look at the environment where they're possibly coming from. So for example, if they're close to where you have a lot of people living, you know where to focus your efforts on by properly educating them to better handle their plastics by well disposing them off or recycling. That way they don't end up in these vulnerable environments. By putting them also on a map, we'll be able to look at changes that have occurred over time by imposing one map on the other. So we can do what we call chain detection, which will give us an oversight of how increasing or decreasing the microplastic pollution is.
The first way to end microplastic pollution is to prevent plastics from getting into the ocean in the first place. One helpful step is to avoid using single-use plastic, or try to use non-plastic materials as much as possible.
We can stop microplastic pollution by getting every citizen to put a little bit of pressure on lawmakers to motivate them to create new rules that help us to preserve the ocean from microplastic pollution.
We need our lawmakers to take action on all levels. That includes state, local, and federal governments.
We all have a role to play by properly disposing of plastics and also trying to recycle them as much as we can.